Why? What's up? Oh, it's you, Mrs. Davidson.
Have you noticed anything unusual tonight, Tony?
No. It's been as quiet as a grave.
Take the drug. Go on, just a spot on your tongue. It's strong stuff.
What about her?
It's all right.
She's seen me.
We'll be out of the country before she comes to. Now get out of here.
Thanks for everything, Kat.
Come on. Erica Davidson?
Oh, the ambulance is here, Mrs. Davidson.
Right. I'll open the inner gate for them.
Thousands of innocent people behind bars. Don't you see? She's the enemy.
Please, we must go.
Kill her.
You silly bitch.
So what? Come on.
We can't just leave here. We can't.
Listen, you join an army, not a hockey team. Come on!
Stop right fire.
What is it? What are they doing?
Crikey, we got more coppers than the kid's money box.
Oh, let's have a look. Who are they shooting at?
Now, how do I know?
Oh, let's have a look and I'll tell
you. Oh, you wouldn't see anything. It's blacker than Vera's heart.
Oh, go on, let's have a look.
Oh, all right, you silly old rat.
Here. Can you see anything?
They're shooting somebody.
You don't say.
Did you check the other block? No change of product with it. Anyone check the pound?
Do you reckon they're the cops?
You better take them.
Yeah.
Who do you reckon they're after?
There was only one person in the pound as far as I know.
That terrorist woman.
Sounds like her mates have come for her.
Thank you.
There's no ham. Your mate scoffed at all.
Doesn't matter.
What does matter to you? I'd like to know.
Leave off, Lee.
You rave on about duty and responsibility, but when the crim is one of your mates...
Jeff is not a crim.
Oh, no, he's just a poofter basher.
I can't dob him in just because you think he did it.
You know he did it. He's done it before and he'll do it again. How much harm does he have to do before you stop him?
Look, stop being so melodramatic, Lee. You don't like him, all right, fair enough. But he'll be out of your hair soon. You heard what he said. He's joining that mob and going off to Africa.
That's another thing. Isn't that illegal?
What?
Being a mercenary.
Oh, rubbish. Well, even if it was, what am I supposed to do? Go along to the police and say, there's this bloke I know, good friend of mine. Saved my life once, actually. But you better arrest him anyway, because he happens to be going off to Africa in a couple of weeks.
Don't be so stupid.
I'm not the one who's being stupid.
He told us he was going to be a mercenary.
Whatever he told us, all we've got to offer the police is hearsay. Hearsay is not proof. It's not even evidence.
What are you going to do about the pub incident? He'll do it again, you know. And if he gets caught, they'll be asking you a few questions. Well, you knew he was a psychopath.
Yes, Fletcher.
It's Officer Edwards. There's been a jailbreak.
Who, Dominguez?
Yes. The police are here.
Anyone hurt?
The governor's been shot. The ambulance men are with her. I've called Dr. Miller, too.
Right, I'll be right over. You better get hold of Miss Bennett and Mrs. Jackson, all right? There's been a jailbreak. Erica's been shot.
Oh, God.
Don't know how long I'll be. Look, when I get this mess sorted out, I'll talk to the police about Jeff. But you keep right out of it. Not a word to anyone. Least of all, Jeff. You keep right out of his way.
Okay.
All right, but please let me handle it, okay?
Be careful, Jim.
I don't want any fuss, Mr. Fletcher. I'm all right. How is she?
Who cares?
Well, she can't be kept in Wentworth. There isn't the security.
Don't you worry about that. The feds are in charge of her now.
Who?
They've called in the Commonwealth Police.
Mr. Fletcher, I've notified the standby staff. They're all on their way. And Miss Bennett and Mrs. Jackson should be here any minute.
Good. Thanks, Officer Edwards. I'm afraid I'm going to have to ask you to stay for a little while longer. They'll want to question you. Try and get some rest, eh?
Yes, sir.
Was anyone else hurt? You have to tell me. I'm still responsible. You've got to tell me. I'm so cold.
Two men in a dark-colored Range Rover. Number plate LXR629. Southeastern sector if you're fast enough. Get a copter up and tell them to check for anything going like a bat out of hell.
They flew in. They could be flying out again.
Oh, and check proper airstrips, okay? Well, Mr. Fletcher, this is no good, is it? Several officers drugged, one concussed, a good man shot, and your governor feeling rather poorly, I believe.
What about them?
Well, they've lost one man, but we've still got Janet Dominguez, though with a few holes in her.
Never should have put her in here.
Well, we weren't to know that the walls were made of lolly paper, were we?
We did our best with what we had. Wentworth was never designed to withstand a terrorist attack.
No, of course not. Well, how is Dominguez?
Our doctor's fishing a couple of bullets out of her.
Well, as long as she's still 100% with us.
Well, staff are ready when you want them.
Good. I'll need to talk to them. Oh, and the prisoners, too.
Well, you won't do much good there, I'm afraid.
But I have to, Mr. Fletcher, and I will. This isn't a minor kerfuffle about an escaped crim. This little lot we're dealing with have notched up 17 victims so far, and the next VIP could be our own. As you can imagine, the big boys back in Canberra aren't too happy at that prospect.
Have you done a head count?
Yeah, they're all here, except Coulson.
Did she share a cell?
Yeah, she was in with Kathleen Leach.
Well, get Leach up here and I'll talk to her after I finish with Dominguez.
It is now 28 past the midnight hour.
Now, come on, you rat bag, give us some news.
First, we have a flash from our newsroom. An attempt has been made to break out hitwoman Jeanette Dominguez from Wentworth Detention Center. Dominguez is being held pending extradition for the suspected murder of a South American diplomat in the recent UN bomb incident. We'll have more in our news.
Well, was that nutcase?
They said attempted. That means they didn't make it. Do you think she got a bullet?
What's Ros I'm worried about? All that shooting.
Maybe she's still here.
Hey, Coulson, you there? Hey, stupid!
That's enough, Smith. Be quiet in there.
Listen, what the hell's going on?
Come on, Leech. Sit up.
She's out cold.
She's taking it. Come on, get up.
Take her feet. We've got to get her looked at.
Ros, are you there?
So what are they doing to Kath?
Hey, Kath, you all right?
I told you women to be quiet.
Ros isn't there.
And I'll tell you why. She's flown the coop with those terrorist bastards. In it up to her neck, stupid little cow.
What do you think she's done to Kath?
Oh, she wouldn't have hurt her, surely.
I have news.
Have both declined to comment. Negotiations are expected to continue over the weekend. The death toll from the Wentworth breakout so far has been 2 dead, 3 wounded. The governor of Wentworth, Mrs. Erica Davidson, was shot during the terrorist attack. Her condition is unknown. And now for the weather details, another...
Davo, what was she doing here?
They said 2 dead.
Oh, I hope they shot the Millers.
One could have been Ros.
Oh, serves her right, silly little bitch.
Oh,
kids. I always think they know better.
Hello, Dominguez. I've come for a little chat.
Local or federal?
How did you know I was a policeman?
Secret police smell the same everywhere.
I want some names.
I am not going out on a stretcher. It looks worse than it is.
You shouldn't be on your feet at all. Jim, can you get the wheelchair? You'll be able to go home tomorrow. Tonight, I want you in hospital. You're lucky that bullet wasn't an inch or two to the right.
I have Coulson to thank for that.
We have Coulson to thank for the whole damn massacre.
She pushed the gunman as he fired. It wasn't my arm he was aiming at. Have they brought her in yet?
No, they're still looking for her. And the whole Dominguez gang.
How is she?
Oh, she'll survive. Not if I had my way. I'd put the whole lot of them in front of a firing squad.
I want the names.
In its struggle for power, the only weapon the proletariat has is organization.
Names, Ms. Dominguez.
It is better to die on one's feet than live on one's knees.
We might yet be able to oblige you. Names!
Mrs. Davidson suffered a wound in the upper arm. I rang the hospital a few minutes ago. They're releasing her today and she's in no further danger.
Thank God for that. What about our other casualties?
Mrs. Edwards has got a nasty headache, but she's okay. Officer Williams and the others are still too dopey to be of much help.
Do they know who dropped the coffee?
Oh, Coulson, of course.
Why, of course?
Well, she was thick with the Dominguez woman. She had access to the urn. And she used the same dope to flatten Kathleen Leach.
And she escaped with them. What else do you need?
How is Kathleen?
Dead to the world, but in no danger.
Well, at least she's getting some sleep.
We're all tired, Meg, but we do have a job to do.
Well, it'd be easier on the remaining staff if we kept the women to a more confined area.
Yes, lock them in their cells.
No, I don't think so. No, cancel all work duties. We can cut down on supervision by restricting them to the recreation areas. They'll be required for questioning most of the day anyway.
But they won't have anything to do.
Well, if you ladies would like to get on with it.
Well, what are we going to tell them about last night?
I'll talk to them at breakfast.
All right.
Oh, and Miss Bennett. If you could inform reception that I'll be with Detective Marshall most of the day, I'll leave you to deal with any general business.
Right.
Is it true that the governor was shot last night, Mrs. Jackson? How is she?
She's in a satisfactory condition.
Yeah, well, satisfactory to her. She got a bullet in her, didn't she?
She's all right. Dr. Miller said she's going to be discharged from hospital this morning.
Oh, thank goodness.
Yeah, I thought we was going to be short of one governor.
What happened to Ros?
I don't know.
Well, she didn't have anything to do with the shooting, did she, Mrs. Jackson?
She wasn't holding a gun, if that's what you mean. Now, hurry up. If you want your breakfast, move it.
Well, what happened to Kathleen?
Mr. Fletcher will tell you at breakfast. Get a move on.
Oh. Bloody Janet Dominguez. We'll teach that comic bitch a bit of that guerrilla warfare.
I wouldn't try. She has a wall of armed police 10 foot thick around her at the moment. Mama.
Who's your fat friend, B? How are you getting on, love?
Oh, I'm taking care of myself all right.
Baby kicking yet?
What, 4 months?
Yeah, well, I'd be kicking if I was locked up inside, Chrissie.
Yeah, well, you're not, are you? You're locked up in here. This kid'll be going to high school before you get out.
Yeah, I'll be letting you out too early either.
I've got my plans. We'll be out of here sooner than you think.
Oh, gonna be a model prisoner, are we, Chrissie?
Yeah, if it means me and the kid'll be out of here sooner, why not?
You're up for murder. You'll be around for a while yet.
Meg, can you take a call in the staff room?
Who is it?
Mrs. Fletcher.
Leela, what does she want?
I don't know, but Mr. Fletcher left strict instructions he wasn't to be disturbed, so she asked to speak to you instead. She sounded worried.
Okay, then. I'll be 3 minutes. Hello, Leela. It's Meg here. What can I do for you? No, he's very busy at the moment. Is anything wrong?
Yes, there is. Did Jim say anything to you about Jeff?
No, what about him?
Well, you don't know whether Jim's rung the police, do you? No, not about that, about Jeff.
Look, Leela, we're in chaos at the moment, so could you get to the point, please? What's Jeff got to do with the police?
The man's dangerous, Meg. What am I supposed to do? Close my eyes and hope it'll all work out? You won't believe me. Jim's too busy to do anything. Meg, it's very important that you listen to me.
Okay, I'll listen, but you'll have to be quick.
Well, you know Jeff went berserk in Sydney, and he nearly killed a man.
Yes, you told me.
Well, the other night he bashed up a man in the local pub. The man's in hospital.
Oh, can't believe it.
You have to, it's true. Meg, I'm not telling tales because I enjoy it. I'm concerned about you. Meg, you there?
Well, yes.
Look, the man's a maniac. He's going to go off the deep end at any minute. For heaven's sake, be careful.
Well, you've known him longer than I have. Well, I'll just do my best to discourage him.
No, don't do that. Oh, God knows what he might do. Just avoid him if you possibly can.
All right, then. Thanks, Leela. Goodbye.
You look exhausted.
Oh, give me the good news. I'm entitled.
Janet Dominguez is doing nicely.
Oh, I was hoping for gangrene.
Ah, the sooner she's fit enough to travel, the sooner she goes.
And good riddance.
Marshall has been giving Kathleen Leach a hard time.
Was Kathleen involved in the breakout?
I doubt it. She's not the stuff of which martyrs are made.
Whereas Roslyn is. Wired to self-destruct, that girl.
Something to say.
Good morning. Now, I'm going to outline the procedure for today, but before I do, I'm going to pass on a message from the Commonwealth Police. Now, as you all probably know by now, Mrs. Davidson was shot by terrorists in an escape attempt from this prison. Now, the wound's not serious. She was very lucky in that.
Excuse me, Mr. Fletcher, whatever happened to Kath?
She's all right. She was drugged. Which brings us to the prisoner Coulson. without whose help the terrorists would never have been able to gain access to this prison. Now, you're all going to be interviewed by the police. Any help that you can give them would be greatly appreciated. Appreciated and rewarded. So it's in your interest to give us any help you can.
Keep away from your friends, because that's the first place anyone's going to look.
How would I do that?
You hang around the wharves, of course. There's always sailors, and they'll always be after a bit.
What was he like?
Marshall? Rat poison with boots on. Good, I'm glad I didn't have anything to do with that Dominguez woman.
What's he after?
Oh, anything as far as I could make out. Strikes me they don't know where to look for these terrorists, and young Ros kept asking me where I thought they was heading.
Oh, that's anyone's guess.
And do you know what? I heard the doc telling Mrs. Jackson that Ros pushed the bloke who shot Mrs. Davidson. Otherwise, old David would be dead by now.
Gosh, she's a funny kid. Mm. One minute she's best mates with a group of commies, next minute she's saving the governor's life.
Well, she probably only helped them so she could escape too.
Don't think much of her chances, not with that mob. Out of the frying pan into the fire, you ask me.
Oh, I wish we could go back to work. It's boring enough in here without having to sit around all day.
Here, why don't you spin him a yarn when it's your turn? Might do yourself a bit of good.
Good, good. Don't try and put anything over him.
Next. Well, don't stand there like a pack of dummies.
No worse than the dentist, ladies.
You, Smith.
Oh, think about it.
You'll come now.
I'll come. I don't mind.
Well, you're next, Smith.
Why do you reckon Chrissy's so keen?
Well, Marshall's a bloke, isn't he?
I've told you everything I know over and over again.
One more time.
I don't know their names. I don't know where they've gone. The last thing I remember is having a cup of coffee and waking up in hospital.
You drank the coffee voluntarily?
Yes.
Knowing it was drugged? Come on, you knew that the coffee was drugged and Coulson offered you a cop-out.
I didn't know anything about it.
You knew she had this instant sleep powder. Why didn't you inform the authorities? You knew she was going to doctor the coffee urn, didn't you?
No.
You could have saved a great deal of bloodshed, Kathleen.
It wasn't my fault.
Oh, I know it didn't turn out the way you expected. You thought that you were just helping your friends.
They weren't my friends.
Well, they're very dangerous friends to have. They kill without a qualm. And we have to find them fast. I don't say your involvement in this can be forgotten, but if you can give us anything useful...
I've told you everything I know.
You still haven't told us where Coulson got the drugs that we traced to her pen.
I don't know.
Think, woman, think. My God, you shared a cell.
Excuse me, Mr. Fletcher. Latham's got some story she wants to tell him.
Well, I'll put on to Sergeant Dawson.
I'll speak to her, Miss Bennett. I've finished with this one for the moment.
Take Leach back to his cell, please, Mr. Jackson.
You got a file on Latham?
Yeah. Bring her in.
So you're the biggie.
Yes, I'm the biggie. What have you got for me?
Something I seen and no one else did.
Well?
What's in it for me?
Depends.
Remission?
Maybe, if your information's worth it.
Come on, Latham, get on with it.
All that shooting woke me up. So I went to the window and I saw Roslyn Coulson. She didn't go off with the others. She made a run for it by herself.
I see.
Any good?
Perhaps. Did you know the prisoner Coulson?
only like anyone else.
Anything you can tell me about her?
For someone whose mum was a pro, she certainly had tickets on herself.
And what do you mean by that?
Well, she thought she was better than anyone else in here, that's all.
Whereas she was just another common murderess.
Not according to her. Reckoned she was righting a wrong.
Felt her sentence was unjust.
Yeah. She didn't cop it sweet.
She'd have been an ideal recruit for the Dominguez mob. They would have smelt her out a mile away. Well, young woman, you can go now.
Well, what about my remission?
I'll take it up with the governor. But of course, if you can come up with something really
useful. Sure. I'll let you know.
Shouldn't you have questioned her further?
Give her time, Mr. Fletcher. Let the girl think on it. She probably knows more than she realizes.
Yeah, but will she tell us?
Oh, she'll tell us.
That was a non-event. You won't get time off for that.
He's going to speak to the governor, he said.
He's got more important things to do.
Leach looked terrible. What did he do to her?
He's given her a pretty hard time.
Is it true she helped the terrorists?
On your way, Latham. Stop hanging around.
Here, Kat. It's me, Chrissie.
What do you want?
I saw Ros last night from the maternity wing. She got away all right.
Yeah, with them bloody nutcases. Probably shot her now.
No, she didn't. She got left behind, so she's on her own.
You sure?
Oh, I saw it, didn't I?
Oh, gee, that's the best news I've heard all week.
Maybe she'll meet up with her mates later on.
Not after she saw the shooting.
Yeah, where's she gonna go? She's got no friends down here, is she?
I don't know.
Oh, she'll be in real strife with no mates. And no money. No civvy clothes. What's she gonna do? Didn't she have no plans?
Oh, no, she said she was going to go with those terrorists.
Of course. If it was me, I'd go down to the docks and get myself a sailor.
What did you say?
How would I do that?
You hang around the wharves, of course.
There's always sailors, and they'll always be after a bit.
Motion study. I've got the time if you've got the motion. You're not going to get a better offer.
Forget your fancy morals, Rose. That's why it's easier for us to get away than it is for blokes.
Yeah, but I couldn't.
Anyone want more coffee?
Thanks. It's all that's keeping me going.
Right. Vera, will you be able to hang on till the next shift?
Oh, I'm all right. I snatched a nap last night.
What? In all that hullabaloo?
It wasn't constant.
Has Marshall finished his interviews yet?
I took in the last batch a half an hour ago.
Good.
Well, at least Coulson didn't get away with her terrorist gang after all her crafty planning. Meg. Coffee.
Thanks.
You won't be able to hang on past lunchtime. You'd better go home then.
No, I'll hold on to the next shift.
Not necessary. I'm having the relief staff come in early.
Oh, thanks.
Well, come on. We better get back.
Jim?
Hmm?
I had a call from Leela. Well, actually, she was trying to get hold of you, but I told her you were busy.
Oh, no. About Jeff?
Is what she said true?
Look, you don't have to worry. I've spoken to the police. They might even clear him.
Well, what do I do in the meantime?
Sergeant Marshall wants to see you, Mr. Fletcher.
Yeah, I'm coming. Meg, I don't know. Perhaps you'd be better off avoiding him till all this has been cleared up.
You came in very quietly.
Yeah, we learned how to move quietly during the last big bash.
Big bash?
Didn't Jim tell you about it?
At some length. At least he no longer feels he's licensed to kill.
Was you who dobbed me into the police, wasn't it?
There's a law against hitting people you don't approve of. Or didn't you know?
Yeah, I knew Jim wouldn't have done it. It had to be you. They picked me up in the golf club. Have you any idea how I felt?
Do you know how that man feels with a broken nose and a ruptured spleen?
He wasn't a man, he was a poofter.
How did you get away from the police?
I walked away. They asked me if I'd beaten a bloke up in a public toilet. I said no and they believed me.
They believed you?
Well, why wouldn't they? I'm an honest citizen with a good army record. Anyway, I was telling the truth.
Like hell.
There I was on the ninth green when they came to get me. Partnered with Colonel Woodward. Damn fine golfer, the Colonel. Mind you, it really put him off his game when he saw the fuzz stomping all over the green. They carted me off like a common crim.
You're worse than a common criminal. You only joined the army for the nice legal killing.
Fine.
You touch me, and the police won't believe you this time.
We'll be moving to Dominguez this afternoon with our own little guard of honor.
Can't be soon enough for me.
Morning, Redwood. You hear that, Dominguez? You'll soon be on the move again. And seeing as you seem to like the company of desperados, we're going to put you in the men's jail. Maximum security wing. Pity your friends had all their trouble for nothing.
They won't fail next time.
You know you lost a man.
That one was always careless.
I wouldn't say that the others were crash hot. DaCosta's trigger happy, and Cooper's all mouth.
Who?
Oh, you know who. The clowns who tried to break you out of Wentworth. If they're typical of your lot, I don't know why you bother.
They still got one of your men.
But they failed in their mission. Failed miserably, and you're still here.
I wouldn't be if it weren't for that stupid girl.
Where is she?
Who?
Come on, Dominguez. She's not one of your mob. We want her back before she gets into any more trouble.
There's an indictment of your society. A woman is better off in jail than she is on your streets.
You must have been a woman before you were a terrorist. Come on, let's hear it for sisterhood.
If it wasn't for that squeamish little bitch, your precious governor would be dead. And at least we'd have accomplished something. I wish Roslyn Coulson in hell.
I'll tell you what that's fair.
Are you kidding?
Princess, changed your mind?
Maybe. Sailing soon?
We're off to Brisbane in an hour, so we can't waste any time, can we?
Would you like to take me with you?
To Brizzy? Yeah, I could fix that.
Thank you.
Brisbane's a long way, so we could have a real cosy trip, you and me. What's your name?
Debbie.
Okay, Debbie. What are you drinking?
Could I have the money instead?
How much?
$1.
Want a stick and some sheep?
I'll meet you at the entrance to the pier in half an hour, okay?
Sure. What have I got to lose except $1? Guess what? I just bought for $1.
I'll have 20 cents for it.
It's not the quickest route, but it's the safest.
But in a laundry van, that's hardly impregnable.
Well, this one is.
Come in.
Excuse me, sir. It's Latham again.
You mean she's thought of something?
She's thought of another way to waste your time.
Never mind, Miss Bennett. We must keep fossicking. Bring her in.
I've worked it out. Where she'd go?
Well, go on, Chrissie.
Well, she asked me once what I'd do if I ever shot through. I told her I'd try and pick up a boat going interstate.
Stow away?
Yeah. Well, she'd be all right with the sailor for a ticket.
Yes. Yes, a pretty girl like Coulson wouldn't have any trouble. Well, thank you, Chrissie. Now, you can go away and think some more. There might be other things you've talked about that you've forgotten.
Well, do I get any remission for this?
Oh, if we catch her, definitely.
You can't promise her remission. You haven't got the authority.
It's not my fault if you lot can't keep my promises.
Hello, love. You look done in.
Oh, hello, Jeff.
I heard about the kerfuffle down at Wentworth. Front page news, eh?
Yes.
Yes, I suppose it was.
I did ring and they said you were on the way home, so I thought I'd take you out to lunch. Put the roses back in your cheeks.
Oh, no, Jeff. I'm just too tired.
Well, you'll feel better after a good lunch.
No, thanks. I just want to curl up and die.
Well, what about if I go to a takeaway?
Look, I'm not hungry. I just want to sleep.
But you've got to eat.
Not today. Please, Jeff.
You're trying to brush me off?
No. Well, yes, maybe I am.
Well, you better have a good reason.
I just don't think it's going to work out.
Well, now, that doesn't sound like my girl, Meg. Now, why don't we just talk this thing over reasonably, shall we?
Man's around, get him out of the way. Tell him the forecastle's on fire. Well, Princess, how'd you spend your dollar?
Here's the change.
Nah, keep it. You're a bit nervous, aren't you? New to the game?
Yes.
Come on, love, relax.
Excuse me, you're Roslyn Coulson?
No, you got the wrong Sheila, mate. This is Debbie, so piss off. Come on, love. He's not from your old man or something.
Miss Coulson knows who we are.
It's like there's been times when I've been too tired to be rational. Why don't you just drink your drink and give us a big smile, eh?
I want out, Jeff.
Well, that's a bit of a change of pace, isn't it?
I had time to think.
Has Leela had anything to do with your thinking?
No, it's got nothing to do with Leela. I've just got over one emotional disaster. I'm not prepared to try again.
Oh, crap!
Look, I can't take that risk.
Leela's really been getting to you, hasn't she?
I can make my own decisions.
And you've decided not to see me again. And you made the decision all on your own, right?
Yes.
Good. I just wanted to get things straight, that's all.
So, will you please go now?
No. No, I don't think I will. Sit down.
It's your turn to get something straight. Nobody gives me the boot.
Do you understand, girl?
Hey, Bert, look who's here. It's that Dominguez bitch, the one who shot the governor. I hope you rot, you commie bitch.
Why don't you go and blow up your own country?
Yeah, why don't you bloody politics to yourself?
Leela, where are you?
Here.
Well, you certainly made a fool of me today, didn't you? Ringing Meg after I told you not to.
Well, somebody had to tell her. You're obviously too busy as usual.
I told you I'd go to the police about Jeff.
But you just couldn't find the time.
I rang them. I told them my suspicions and left it at that.
So it was you then?
Who else?
He told me he was picked up at the golf course by the police. He thought I'd dobbed him in.
They let him go?
Amazing, isn't it?
But he must be innocent.
Innocent? He practically told me he did it. It wasn't a man, he said. It's only a poofter.
Where is he now?
I don't know. He went out.
Out? Where? Meg.
Leave it.
It was ringing. I better get over there. Ring the police.
If you want to be treated like a lady, you behave like one. Fair enough?
I said fair enough!
Yes. Yes, that's the magic word. Now, a lady doesn't lead a bloke on and then dump him like a load of old garbage. She does what she's told and she doesn't get hurt. Ah, good day there, fella. Come on in. Get her old mate a glass, Meg.
You all right?
She's all right.
Did you do that?
Well, you know how it is, mate. You've got to be firm with women and wogs.
Anything broken?
It's just bruises.
Don't worry, the police are on their way.
Oh, the police! Ha-ha, good old Leela's been at it again, eh?
I call the police.
Well, whatever for?
You're getting a bit too free with your fists for my liking.
Oh, now, that's not the old Jimmy I always knew. Not my old army, mate. I can remember times when you'd wade in when the odds were 10-1 against.
Yeah, you might recall I've never hit a woman.
Well, that's because of that sour bitch of a wife of yours. She's really got you knackered, mate. Now, look, why don't you come over to Africa with me? That's where the really big bickies are. And I tell you what, I can make you an offer you can't refuse.
Since when are you making offers?
Since always, mate. I've got together a group of the roughest, toughest guys you've ever heard of. They'd even scare the Genghis Khan. And if you want to be 2IC, you've got it.
Wait a minute, you've been recruiting all this time?
You didn't tumble to it, eh? Insurance. You've got to admit, it's not a bad cover, though.
You're crazy. Recruiting's illegal.
So what are you going to do? Slap my hand?
I don't have to. The police will do that. Come on, Meg.
Now, just where do you think you're going?
Out. Meg?
Sorry, fella.